if you want to do any questions and answers from anybody, if we can kind of keep it like somewhat organized or whatever, I'd be happy to do that.
Obviously, you know, Fred, this is not the first time the Raiders have played in London. Can you tell me a little bit about your experience when you were here last time in London, and what you think about the experience this time?
Don't come in August. But no, we came back years ago when I was coaching. We played an exhibition game there, and you know, we had an opportunity to be here for about almost a week, and we had a great time. It was hot as hell. We still had a great time. So let's get rolling with everybody in the chat.
Okay, anybody got any questions that they want to put to
this
way, the Reverend Carl. The Reverend Nelson wants you. That's your humor. And I want to know what it's like to have such an honor as the Reverend Carl brings to you.
Coach the team!
You want to coach the team?
Yeah!
I have no the coaches are down on the sideline, and it's not an easy job, you know, because, you know, your livelihood depends on those guys when they go out on the field, you know, and you can only do so much, you can do so much coaching, and now these guys are going to play. You know, we could all say, I'm like one of you now. What the hell they call that damn play for? Yeah. Yeah. But you know something? They call a play, if it's right or wrong, good or bad or whatever, just get your ass out there and make it play. And so on. So everything has to fall on the players too. You know, and those guys got to go out there and perform. You know, it's just like, when you're a coach and you're coaching a position or a head coach, it's like having a family of kids. You know, you don't know what the hell that kid's going to do today or tomorrow or whatever, or that day or whatever like that, you know. So that's what you're dealing with. You know, you gotta be, before you are a coach, you're going to be a father, a psychiatrist, a social worker, all this stuff, and now you're a coach. It's non-ending. It goes on a daily basis, and that's not an easy job, coach. I mean, your livelihood. I mean, I don't know how many people in this room would want to say, okay, well, I'll take the responsibility of somebody else going out there and doing this job that I own this business for, and you got to hope they go out and do the job for you. Okay, and that's what football is. That's it. You know, and so you know, those kids just got to go play. It's bottom line.
And tonight, the next question is for Les Wilkie from Gordon, England. Hi, Fred. Thanks for coming tonight. And you both want to see the great insight that seems worth all. But you think the fans of time realize that it's not to let a certain black light in the last of the year again?
Yes, Brad.
The question is actually, the real pain though, how the players like wearing the silver black and white meant to wear the silver black, and do today's current players see up that same for the second.
They make more money. You know, if you're not making a lot of money, and you have to save your ass and save your job, you're not going to play your ass off.
Yeah,
and now, when you're giving all this money, you got to go out there and play. My last year playing, after 14 years, I made $157,000 US. Okay, after four years, okay? And then you go through like